Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Pat, and welcome back to another mod showcase. And today, we're going to take a look at the Shipwreck mod. It makes your beaches and oceans feel much more alive in your Minecraft world. If you look around, there are a bunch of different ships. Your world actually won't look like this, though. I changed the config so I could easily show you guys all the different structures that generate. So they don't just look cool, but there are some pretty good treasures you can get on these structures as well. So we'll check out this ship first. And you see right here, its sail is like totally messed up. It's because the ship, you know, crashed into land. And they're all going to look a little bit different. So every time you see this ship, you know, the sail is going to be a little bit different. Like right here, it's like broken and like over the side of the ship. But we're going to go inside here and go down and check it out. So this room right here, there is a chest. You're actually going to notice that something else, a captain's log, will be in here. But when you click on it, it just disappears. So it's not really anything yet. There's an empty map and a compass. So nothing too special in here, and yeah, mobs can easily spawn because it can be pretty dark. There's some bookcases, but in this room, there's a bunch of different dispensers and they all have arrows in them. And I think they can have up to 8 in each one. So you can get a bunch of arrows like really easily. Plus there's like skeletons here too. That's probably why they're here. Here for the arrows, aren't you, bro? But if we head over here, we can actually head down even further. So this section of the ship, there's like a bunch of beds in it. And if you go through here, and there actually is no way to open this door, you gotta like break it down. And there is a nice emerald block and an iron block in here. But how it's gonna be is there's always gonna be an iron block and then another random block, which can either be emerald, diamond, or gold. I got pretty lucky, got this one. And there is a chest right here. This one happens to have a saddle and 3 bread. And I showed you guys this ship that was on land on purpose because the ones that are off into the ocean are really hard to go through. I mean, they're completely filled with water and really difficult to actually get to the bottom of. And in a normal Minecraft world, you'll probably easily drown just trying to get to the bottom and get all the cool loot. So I showed you this giant ship. There also are some pretty tiny ones, like this one right here. Little tiny boat. It does have a chest on it, though. And it has some iron ingots, gunpowder, bread, and a gold ingot. One of the interesting things is sometimes this ship can be like turned on its side. I think there was one over here. And the chest like falls out of the ship and is like a little bit away from it. So yeah, guys, I actually found one. This one is on its side. It's the same boat except, you know, it tipped over, I guess, when it hit land. And a chest is going to be like a random amount away from the boat. And I believe this is it right here. So in here we have gunpowder, iron ingots, bread, buckets, and an ender pearl. Pretty cool. So yeah, sometimes you're gonna find them like on their side with the chest a little bit away from it. I figured I might as well show you guys the most boring boat as well. It is this one. It's kind of just for looks, you know? It's for looks. There really isn't anything here. And you'll see these every once in a while. If you really need the wood though, I mean, you could take the wood. That's something, I guess. It's better than nothing. And this right here is the last ship in the mod. It's a pretty big ship though. And you can see it really got destroyed when it hit the land. Like, the sails are decrepit and hanging over the sides. But there are dispensers on deck, and they all do have arrows in them. So this is, like, a really nice way to grab some arrows very quickly. See, there's a ton. So we're gonna go inside and see what there is. And it is pretty dark, so make sure to bring some torches. There are 3 bales of hay, a pumpkin, and a melon. I love when mods add in a melon, because in vanilla Minecraft, it is so hard to get the seeds. There's a couple chests down here, but I don't think they actually have anything in them. Nothing in there. Nothing in there, and there is some coal though, and there's an anvil and also a furnace, but there's nothing in that. But there is one more room back here with a nice reward. So there is a chest and a lot of beds like right next to each other. I would not want to sleep in here, not at all. But in the chest there are a couple emeralds in this one, some iron ingots, a bucket, and some bread. So pretty nice reward in this chest. Really wouldn't want to be the person that sleeps in here. Looks terrible. So I showed you guys all the ships generating on land, but a lot of the times you're going to find them in the water. And it is so hard to make your way through them. I'm just going to go in this one real quick and show you guys what it looks like. Like, you can't tell what's going on, and sometimes, like, freaking dirt and sand generate in it as well. So we'll make our way down here. Really hard to tell what I'm doing. And here's the first chest. And like I mentioned before, there is a captain's log. And for whatever reason, when you grab this and you right click on it, it disappears. They're probably going to do something with it in like a future update to the mod. All right, break this door down. And this one actually has a diamond block in it. In the chest, an iron sword, gunpowder, a bucket, and bread. And I know you guys can't see anything. I can't see anything either. So I'll get out of there. But anyways, guys, if you want to check this mod out, the download is in the description. And if you enjoyed the review, I'd really appreciate it if you left a like and subscribed. It really does help me out. Thanks for watching, guys.